Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about how to display toast and snack bar in .NET Maui application using a package known as community2k.maui. So thanks to the Microsoft community team, they have a package that can help us integrate toast and also snack bar in application. If you don't know what toast or snack bar is, don't worry, because in this video, we're going to cover the two features here, and these features are amazing. The integration is very easy and simple. Let's first start with the toast, how to integrate toast into our application. When you develop your application and user interacts with the application, you would like to give feedback to the user, isn't it? So in such case, I've made a video on how to use display alert, display action sheet, and also display prompt async. You can use that to interact with the user. But when you use this toast too and snack bar, it is all cool. So let's see. Maybe you can watch that video and watch this also. The two lessons you can compare and see how to use any of them. But let's focus on the toast and snack bar for now. So what you need to do here first is to create .NET Maui app project. And I've launched my Visual Studio 2022. So I'm going to click on new project. Then I'm going to select on .NET Maui app. So I'm going to give it as demo. Next. The framework is 7.0. So create project. Let's wait for the project to get created. I believe you're also doing the same. So the project is ready now. Now, the first thing that we need to do here is we have to install this package, and that is a community2k.maui package. So let's start doing that. Okay, so we go to the dependencies and click on any of these platform packages, and these are the packages that we need to install. We have to install community2k.maui, and also we have to install community2k.mvvm. So these are the two packages that we're going to use in this application or this demo. So if you don't know how to install it, right click on dependencies and go to manage NuGet packages, and I'll type the name under the browse tab and I'll try to install the two packages here. Okay, so let's assume you are done installing. Now the next thing that we can do here is we have to configure or use this community2k.mvvm .maui package. So we have to do that. Initialize that package inside the maui-program.ts file. And that is this one. So we open it, and here we're going to say .use maui community. So maui community toolkit. So this name here needs a namespace as a reference. So use this community2k as a namespace. Let's save that. Now the next thing that we're going to do here is let's go to our main page and let's have a button. Like you see, we have a button here. So we're going to clear this name because we don't need this name here. And let's also clear this. Let's click on, let's clear this too. So the test for this is going to be, so let's say this is toast. So display toast. So when I click on this button, I want to display toast. Now let's create a class, and that's going to be view model. So this is view model class. And now this view model, it is linked to this main page. So here, this we're going to say, let's make it public first. So public partial class. And this has to inherit from observable object. So observable objects. Let's see if we have that here. Okay, now we create. So in here, this is what we're going to do. Now let's have a button. So this is public async, and that's six. Let's say this is toast button. It's not task, it is toast button. So this toast button, that is what we are going to do. Now, when this is clicked, when this button is clicked, we want to create a cancellation token. Then let's make it cancellation token source. So we have the token source. Then we can create an instance of this. We set equal to new one. Then let's create a variable for the toast. Then we can say that toast dot make toast. So dot make. And now in here, you need to specify some parameters here. That's a message. So let's say, please display some content. And you know, this must be in double quotes. So let's cut this like this. Let's close this for now. So this is what you want to do. Now in here, let's say toast dot, then we're going to say show. Because as you can see, we have toast dot, we have a lot duration, dismiss, show, dispose. So you want to say show. Then in here, we're going to pass in the cancellation token. So we're going to say cancellation token, and that is a token source. So this one dot, and then we can go for the token in it. Okay, so this is what we have. Now it is saying that, okay, so let's see if we can await this. Now this is what we want to do. So let's bind. Now before we do that, let's make this a relay command. So relay command. Now this is MVVM. So let's go to the main page. Let's bind the context here first, so we can clear all this. Let's clear this too. Now in here, let's say that view model. And we say view model. Let's bind the context. So here we can say binding context. So binding context here is equal to view model. Let's register this in the maui.program.cs. So let's register the content page and net view model. So we say builder.services.addTransient, or let's add singleton. Then we're going to say view model. Then the same thing goes to services.addSingleton. Then here it's not going to be iLogger, rather it's going to be main page. Okay, let's come to our main page.xaml file. Let's add the view model here. So xm, then we give it as, we say view model is equal to namespace, then demo over here. Now let's specify the data type too. So x data type, the name that we gave was view model. So view model, then we can grab this view model. So this button, we can now bind it as command. So we can say that binding to, then toasts. So toast button command. Let's save this. Now let's use Android. Now let's run our application and see what happens.
So now let's click on the display toast button and see what happens now. So as soon as I click on it, you can see we have even the image here, and please display some content, and we have the image logo as you can see from here. So that's the way to display toast. Now not only this, there are some few things that we can also do. Let's have a look at them. So if you check the documentation for toast in Microsoft, you can see from here, we have the duration. You can specify duration, also font size. The default size is, I think, 14, that is here. And the duration, you can see we have duration.short and we have duration.long. Now, these long and short have been explained down here. The short is, I think, 2 seconds, and the long is 3.5 seconds. So if you want to specify those components, then we can go to this and now grab the settings over here so we can use them. So let's grab this. Let's go to our application. Now in here, let's paste them here. So you see, we have our string. We have our, so the string here, we're going to cut this and we're going to put it here. Then we have toast duration. We have a font size, so default is 14. And in case you want to make it as 18, you can do that. So in here is a matter of specifying. The first one is a test. Then the second one here is the duration. So duration. And the last one here, it is a font size. So font size. We are good to go. So let's save this. And now let's see if hot reload, you know, work. Okay, so I don't know if, let's make it 20 and see. So 28. Click on this. Okay, so it means it is not enabled. Now we can refresh or restart this application from here. Then we're going to see the duration. So here we are specifying the short. That is 2 seconds. We can talk about long as well. So dot long. We have dot long too. So duration dot, and we have long. And this long is about 3.5 as stated earlier on. Okay. Now let's see. Now let's click on this button. So you can see the font size has increased and the duration too has turned to short. So that is a way to display the toast. It's very simple. And now see the location beneath down of the application or the phone. Okay, now let's talk about snack bar. Snack bar is also the same as the toast, just that this time around the snack bar has a button that you can perform an action when it is clicked. As you can see from here, the toast displays only the message. There's no button here, but when I use the snack bar, I'm going to have a button that I can click on it. So when I can click on that button. Okay, so that is what we are going to talk about. Now let's have a look on that. So in doing so, let's also add a button here. So we can, so let's create a button. I'm going to say display snack bar. Now let's create the method here. So public, we have async task, and this is snack button. So with this, what can we do here? With the snack bar, we can also configure it by creating the same cancellation token. So let's create our token. We can configure some steps here. When you check the documentation of this, you can see with the snack bar, you can specify some parameters or some properties in it. Now, the first one to do here is, let's see. So that is it. As you can see here, we create our cancellation token from this type. And now you can see we are creating an instance of this snack bar, and we are passing in the background color, the text color, action button color, corner radius, font, and action button font, and also character spacing. So we can do a whole lot of this. Now let's see. So let's grab this. Let's go to our project. So we paste this here. And this font, let's see what we can do. So Microsoft.Maui font. Now also, after doing that, let's see what we can do next. So we can specify the test for the snack bar, the action button test, and also what should happen when we click on this button. Then the time it should wait. So from 3 seconds. So let's also grab this. And in here, we can specify this here. So now as you can see,
here we are going to display alert. So with this, to display alerts, we have to use shell.current.displayAlert. Okay, so we are going to display alert, display this the screen. It's going to take 3 seconds from that. After doing that, what can we do again? You can see we create the snack bar and now we pass in the parameters that we specify for button, action, duration, and the snack bar options. And let's do that beneath here. So you can see we have the text. So there is snack bar. We have the action. And that's what we're going to do when the button is clicked. Now, which button is going to be clicked? This is the action button text. So click here to dismiss. That's the button text. Now, the duration that I'm going to take here is from 3 seconds. And the snack bar options are the color red, green, and etc. So with this, we can change this to light blue. Let's see, the next thing that we have to do is we've created a cancellation token, so we have to utilize it in the snack bar. So to do that, we have to copy the last line here, and that is what we need to use. So the last one, we paste this. So snackbar.show. The same thing applies to this. You see snackbar dot, we have action button, anchor, dismiss, dispose, duration, show, test, visual options, and that's what we specify over here. Okay. So let's save this and let's refresh our application to see what snack bar is going to do for us. Now, if I click on the snack bar, see what happens. So yes, this is not displayed because we did not bound to the button. So let's say this is relay command. And let's go to the main page. Now, with this snack bar, we're going to say that it is bound to snack bar. So before this can work, unless we stop this. Now let's see. So snack bar button, we save that. And now let's run it again. So for now, let's click on the snack bar and see. So as you can see, this is a snack bar. And click here to dismiss. Now, if you don't click it quick, it's going to be dismissed because we specify the time that it should take. Okay, so see something over here. If I click on this button, then it's going to display this to us. So you can use a snack bar as a confirmation because it has a button that the user can click on it. But the toast has no button in it. Both of the snack and the toast display beneath the page, but the snack bar has a button in it that you can just click. So when you check the settings over here, you could see we have the duration. That is time span from 3 seconds. So let's see, when you make it 30 seconds, let's see what happens. So save this. Let's refresh this. So let's click on the button and see. So you can see it's going to stick to 30 seconds for me to click this. Now, if I don't click, it's still going to stay there until the whole 30 seconds is out. As soon as I click on this, let's see what happened to. Now it is off now. So here, the time span here, it is showing you the time that it needs to take when the button is not clicked. As soon as the button is clicked, it disappears. So, you know, this snack bar and toast are beautiful features that we can integrate in our application, especially for interactivity. That is it for this video. I hope today we've covered how to use toast and how to use snack bar from .NET Maui application. If you like watch this video, you can just give it thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you like what I'm doing too. We have a lot of videos and lessons and projects in our playlist, so you can just check them out, and you're going to have informative lessons too. All right, so thank you so much for watching, and I'm sure I'm going to see you again in the next video.